Click the like, subscribe, and the notification bell. It helps the Talisman to keep theatre alive.
Funeral.
Guy's too kind.
This jerk
reckons that I can't go 1 minute
without lighting a cigarette.
1 minute!
Ha! Showed him.
So time to celebrate.
That is one of the great things about
the magic white cylinder.
It's perfect for any occasion.
Talking with friends.
The chat cigarette.
Out with colleagues.
The social cigarette.
Having a few drinks.
The boozy cigarette.
Having a few more drinks.
The boozier cigarette.
Taking a quick break from work.
The promenade cigarette.
Not smoko or fag break.
Promenade cigarette.
Much more style.
Which is what cigarettes are all about.
S-T-Y-L-E.
Style.
What a great meal. I'm stuffed.
The après-dinner cigarette.
Cigarettes always taste better after an excellent dinner.
That is, if it's possible for cigarettes to taste better than they already do.
Nothing happening.
The broad cigarette.
Impressing the new man.
The looking cool cigarette.
Breaking up with the new man.
The broken-hearted cigarette.
Out for a country drive.
The cruise cigarette.
Pack of holiday slims, thanks.
The cheap cigarette.
I love you. You're my best friend.
The shared cigarette.
I'm broke and this is my last one.
The definitely not shared cigarette.
Relaxing in the pergola.
The outdoor cigarette.
Isn't it interesting how many times smoking is linked with relaxing here?
My parents don't know I smoke.
The illicit cigarette.
On a yacht.
The wind and the waves
on
cigarette.
A plane.
The dangerous cigarette.
In a petrol station.
The very dangerous cigarette.
I don't like the term.
Fag.
Ciggy.
Smoke. I prefer to call them by their full name,
cigarette.
Derived from the fact that it is a smaller version of its antecedent.
Anti-who?
Cedent.
Ancestor.
Which was?
The cigar.
But whereas cigars are
big,
heavy,
awkward,
the cigarette is
dainty,
elegant,
convenient,
and fits perfectly well between my
dainty,
elegant,
conveniently well-shaped for holding a cigarette
fingers.
I remember my first cigarette. That moment of
realisation.
Inhalation.
Excitation.
An awakening of
spirit.
Awareness.
Lungs.
An epiphany. I used to hide around the corner and watch him.
Standing on the veranda.
Leaning in the doorway.
Hair slicked back.
Dark blue vest.
And gripped in his
long tanned fingers.
The constant flickering glow.
I pinched one of his
Kents
from the crushed top pack
on the kitchen table,
lit it on the stove,
and after just one puff,
I knew
between coughs,
I had discovered a secret
friend,
conspirator,
lover,
God.
You can also just call them by their brand.
That is also acceptable.
As in,
hand me a lucky strike.
Care for a Dunhill?
Got any camels?
Would you care to share a Jatan?
Which brings us to another of the great attractions of cigarettes.
Their international
flavour.
Cigarettes from all over the world.
Many of which I have tried.
One time or another.
English brands.
Dunhill.
Benson and Hedges.
Subtle.
Smooth.
Rich.
And classy.
Parliament. Very classy.
Barclay.
Bond Street.
American brands.
Salem. Winston.
L&M.
LA Lights.
West Coast.
Mustang Filters.
East Coast.
Cool.
Kent.
The Family Blend.
Newport.
Winchester.
The Heavyweights.
Philip Morris.
Rothmans.
Asian Brands.
Eve 120s.
Jerome Filter.
Kim Slims.
I love Kim Slims.
Mild 7.
Asian cigarettes have the coolest names.
Not to mention roll-ups.
Drum.
Champion Ruby.
Dr. Pat. European brands. Capri, Cartier, Marie, Monte Carlo, Pall Mall. Let me know if I forget any here. More?
I can't think of any more.
More as in the brand.
Oh, whoops.
Multi-filter.
Dull name.
But not bad,
surprisingly.
Vogue Slims, Virginia Slims, and one of my personal favourites, Yves Saint Laurent. picture me in a small corner shop in Paris?
At the counter.
Dressed in white.
Hat, scarf.
Sunglasses.
Dior from head to toe.
To die for.
One packet of Yves Saint Laurent, merci.
Which brings me to another of my favourite things, the cigarette fantasy.
I've got a cigarette fantasy. I smoke 10,000 cigarettes all at once.
Simultaneously?
No, one after the other. Now, I know that sounds like a lot of cigarettes, but actually, look at this. Now, one packet is 20 cigarettes.
A score?
Not very big, is it? In fact, it's tiny. So you times that by 5 and you get...
100.
Still quite small. Times that by 10.
1,000?
Still not a lot, and then by 10 again.
10,000?
By 10.
100,000?
By 10.
1,000,000 cigarettes?
In this fantasy, I'm in the most luxurious palace.
Silver and gold.
Heavy oak furniture.
Polished marble floors.
High ceilings.
Tall windows.
Framed portraits.
History.
Majesty.
Class.
This house is not my house.
It is a fabled Shangri-La of cigarette lovers.
Across the globe.
The Palace of Cigarettes.
Le Palais de Cigarettes.
Cigarette heaven.
Once I enter Le Palais de Cigarette, a butler...
Very regal.
With a voice that sounds like vintage port meets...
Golden syrup.
Greets me.
Good evening, ma'am.
He bears an engraved silver tray.
And on the tray is...
One lone cigarette.
And a silver lighter.
Silver.
Not gold.
Stylish.
Not ostentatious.
Now, at first, I'm a little less than pleased by this.
One cigarette, is that it?
But I have no need to worry.
I light up my cigarette and he leads me up an ornate staircase.
To a hall which opens onto hundreds and hundreds of rooms.
The hall seems to go on and on, forever.
He leads me towards the door.
I knock on the solid heavy timber.
And in a second, the door is opened.
And I'm confronted by...
A cowboy in leather boots and a red check shirt.
He takes me into the room, which is...
An old-style Wild West saloon.
And sits me down at a battered wooden table.
He pours me a shot of...
Maker's Mark.
And he pulls out a dusty packet of...
Marlboros.
Tucked underneath his bootstrap.
He offers me one and lights it.
With a wax-tipped match.
We sit and drink and smoke and chat about his life and times, and then...
Before I know it...
I'm back in the hall.
Butler by my side.
This way, ma'am.
Then I'm knocking on another door, and I'm backstage.
At the Moulin Rouge.
Surrounded by hundreds of gorgeous showgirls!
In the most incredible costumes.
We huddle in the corner of their cramped dressing room.
Puffing on gauvoise.
Giggling.
And gossiping.
About the glamour of the stage.
And the mysterious stranger who always sits at the back table.
Face half covered in shadow.
Who is rumored to be...
A very wealthy crown prince.
With an eye on one of the showgirls.
Moi.
No, moi.
No, moi.
No, moi.
Now I'm on the set of a...
A Fellini movie.
With the most beautiful woman of all time.
Claudia Cardinale.
In my humble opinion.
We are in a dressing room.
Smoking a Zene Triplo.
And I'm trying to console her.
Forget Frederico's wild mood.
Trust in your own gift.
Your pure talent. Your
magnificent beauty.
Another room and I'm in...
Moscow. The day before the October Revolution.
Sitting across the table from...
Vladimir Ilyich Lenin.
With a stoic knife in hand.
The cigarette, not the vodka.
Plotting the Tsar's downfall.
In another room,
there's the whole of the Sydney cricket ground.
I'm in the Aussies' dressing room, sharing a...
Stoivo with Warnie.
Then Adam Gilchrist says...
Hey, you're not allowed to smoke in here.
Wuss.
Warnie just laughs and hands me another. Next, I'm in a...
Tokyo restaurant.
Prague cafe.
Munich beer hall.
Beijing square.
London club.
Every room.
Another destination.
Another time.
Another magical companion.
All linked by our universal passion.
The greatest invention of all time.
The glue that holds mankind
and womankind
together.
Le Palais de Cigarettes.
A living...
Breathing...
Interaction.
Smoker's museum.
Mausoleum.
They had a brand of cigarettes called Death once, didn't they?
Yeah, it was cool.
It was in a black packet with like skull and crossbones.
Brilliant.
We loved it.
Pity the cigarettes inside were so crap.
Death cigarettes. Pretty ironic.
Non-smokers think the danger aspect of smoking is a real turn-off.
Wrong!
Smokers love the danger.
Cheating the Grim Reaper.
They put their pathetic warnings on cigarette boxes.
Spend all this money on tacky ads.
Offer us nicotine patches.
How to quit classes.
Breakthrough weekends.
Spiritual healing.
Wrong.
Wrong.
Wrong. Don't you understand? If we wanted to stop smoking, we would.
I will give up, just not today.
Like that poet once said, there's something, something.
A half love with easeful death.
He was talking about smokers.
Because we recognise that in the end life is...
fleeting.
Transient.
Momentary.
And trying to hold on to it is like...
trying to catch smoke.
In the palm of your hand.
Or maybe we just like smoking too much to give a damn.
Sorry.
I think they should start up a cigarette smokers' hall of fame.
Entry only available for those who have smoked...
1 million cigarettes.
Sorry.
Now, you might think that is impossible, but I've worked it out. If you started, let's say, 14 years of age, and you smoked and a half a day, not that hard, I do that occasionally, you'd be ready for the hall by the time you were... Now, that would be... I wonder if anybody's... Maybe I could be the... the very first to enter the...
Maybe you should reduce the number.
500,000?
100,000?
50,000? 10,000.
You sounded just like...
Dad.
He lay on a hospital bed for 2 months, coughing just like that. Still didn't stop. He'd sit out on the veranda
of the hospital
in a wheelchair, smoke pouring out of the little plastic hole they dug into his throat. Doctors had given up trying to make him quit. What was the point? Right to the very end, died with the constant flickering glow
of a Kent
in his filthy yellow fingers, still wearing that stupid blue vest. He was 47, wife and 4 daughters.
Who? All.
Smoke.
Nice funeral.
Not really.
What you need to understand is the trick isn't stopping. It's not starting in the first place. I'll go for 2 minutes this time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.